Hey, and welcome to another video. So today we're talking more about firmware, but specifically we are going to upgrade IP camera firmware today. So this is a little bit more complicated than our other videos, just because there's so many IP cameras from Hikvision. But we have one normal camera and we have a PTZ camera. I'm going to update the firmware and it should be pretty easy with the list I put together for you guys. Alright then, so if you've seen in our previous videos, you should be able to update the NVR and DVR firmware now. If you've had no problems there, you should find this pretty easy. Okay then, for those of you who haven't done it, you will need to download SADP tool and make sure your camera's on the local network to your PC. Okay then, there are plenty of videos about SADP and you should be able to get it in pretty easily. Alright then, so what I've done is I've plugged in two cameras and we're going to upgrade them. Okay, so where to go? All right then, so if you go to our website and go to technical support, and then you see the latest firmware links, IP camera firmware. We're here now. All right, so if you click on this top link, it will take you to the Hikvision portal. As you see though, there is a lot of complicated information here. Lots of letters and numbers that probably mean nothing to most people. But don't worry, I've made it nice and easy so you can find the correct firmware. Okay. So that's the link, and for PTZs, where you click on this link. A little bit different for PTZs, we'll go over that in a minute. Let's take one thing at a time. All right, so we have two cameras we're gonna talk about today. Upgrade today, I should say. This is one of our two-way audio cameras. So we take the model number here and copy this, then go to our list. Go control, find. Okay, it's found it. So we know this is on the G3 platform, so we click on here. All right then, it takes us here. So it's a little bit tricky, but our model number is the 2346G2. So if you see here, it's the 2XX6G2 models. So this is the one we need here, right here. Okay, we don't need the PDF, we just want the zip file here. So click on download, and it started downloading the update. Okay, so while it's downloading there, I'm gonna log into our camera. So we use our SADP tool for this. So find the camera, okay, double click on the IP address, brings up the login and menu. So we go admin and password, and it's not password 123. Okay, so we're on our camera now. All right then, you can see me and the boss there, but no problems. Okay, then our sort of firmware is up downloaded. So let's just open this quickly. Okay, so take this, I'll show you, download, this is a zip file, so we have to extract all. Okay, extract. All right then, and now it's extracted it into this folder here. So DigiCap, that's what we want. All right then, so now we're on our camera. Let's go to configuration. All right then. So from here, we're already on maintenance, that's perfect. You go to system, then maintenance, and we can upgrade the firmware here. So it says firmware upgrade, browse. Click on browse. Okay, we don't want to go there, so we go downloads here, DigiCap, open. All right then, so as simple as that, and we click on upgrade. Device will automatically reboot, perfect. And it's upgrading. So now we don't have to do anything. It's just going to upgrade, reboot the camera. We might have to log in again. But once that's done, it's out of our hands. The upgrade has been done. All right, so that's how you upgrade an IP camera. Okay, it's a little bit tricky. Like I said, some of these model numbers can be a bit funny. So, but I have made a list here of all the model numbers that I'm aware of. So like I said, if there's something missing, just let me know and I can add it on. Okay, now we're going to go to the PTZ. So this is our PTZ we are going to upgrade. So let's take the model number here. Okay, well, this one's upgrading. So this is PTZ. So we want to go to my list here that I've made. So we go here. All right, now to find the list, luckily Hikvision have done a nice little Excel file here. So download. And we open up the Excel file. Okay, now here we have a list of all the PTZs. So what I prefer to do is just go control F, find the PTZ, find next. Okay, it's found it. Let's find where it is. Okay, it's here. Okay, so it's on the R7 PTZ dome. Okay, up here. So now R7 is here. Thank you. Okay, there's two options. This is a normal one and there's explosion proof. Don't think our little mini PTZ is explosion proof, not quite yet. One day soon, hopefully. Okay then, so we want to download the latest version here. Alright, so just go by the numbers usually. It's the best way. Sometimes these dates are not very accurate. As you see here, this one is 8 months older, but it's a previous version. Hikvision, please sort this out. But what we're going to do is download the latest one, 5.6.15. Okay, so we click on here and then we download the file. All right then, so that's downloading. Let's go check on our other camera. Still upgrading, shouldn't be long now. Okay, rebooting, perfect. So just takes a, it can take a few seconds, a couple of minutes to upgrade. All right, now that one's done. All right, we can probably log on to our camera as well. Oh, this does it. So here is our PTZ. Let's log in. Okay. All right, we're on to our PTZ. Okay, let's go to configuration. And we're going to system again, maintenance. Okay, so before we do that, remember we have to extract the file. So I go downloads. Okay, this is our new PTZ. Okay, extract, okay, and there we go. So this is our PTZ file. So let's browse. Okay, sometimes the menu won't pop out, but you've got to click on it yourself. Just be careful there, guys. And then we go to R7, okay, DigiCap, upgrade, yes. Okay, that's upgrading. Let's go check on our other camera, still rebooting. Yeah, it should be there soon. Let's go check out SE up. I just heard it click, so it should be done. All right, I think we are upgraded on the first camera. I just let it do its thing. And this one's upgrading. As you see, guys, yep, I've done all the hard work but on our website. It's a public page, so feel free to go here to get your latest firmwares. But yeah, hopefully you shouldn't have too many problems and you can now run the latest updates on all your cameras. Okay, this one's done. As you see now, it's booted us out and we have to log in again. So let's just quickly make sure it's worked. Admin. Okay. All right then, so let's try and find what version we're on. So firmware version 5.5.131. Build 200,220. All right then, so let's go back to our links. It's still there. Okay, it was this one, and yep, I don't know that. I get 5.5.131.200,220. Okay, so that's worked. The latest firmware is now on here. And this one's still rebooting, but I know I practiced earlier that one, and it's going to work just fine. So okay, I hope you guys keep your cameras up to date now and should have no problems. So thank you for watching and see you next time. Cheers.